my colleagues in the board of Oil India and NRL, all officials of Oil and NRL, employees and their family present here today, ladies and gentlemen, a very, very good morning to all of you. First and foremost, I take this opportunity to extend my warm and heartfelt greetings on the occasion of the 30th Foundation Day of New Maligarh Refinery Limited. I feel extremely privileged and fortunate to be present here on this auspicious day and take part in the celebrations. On this momentous occasion of NRL Day, I extend my commendation to each and every member of the NRL family for their constant efforts in raising NRL to the stature that it currently enjoys. I would like to offer my salutations to the pioneering leaders who laid the foundation of this great organization, as also all former employees who nurtured this company with their sweat and toil. Foundation Day gives us an ideal opportunity to celebrate the accomplishments of the company while reminiscing its eventful, challenging, yet star-studded journey. In doing so, let us also take out a moment to introspect on what we could have done better and ponder on the road ahead. Completing 29 years of extraordinary accomplishments year after year is indeed a glorious achievement for any organization. In these years, NRL has earned the well-deserved distinction of a respected public sector undertaking in the oil industry, a model corporate entity, and a torchbearer of good corporate governance. Needless to say, it is one of the most visible and important manifestations of the historic Assam Accord. Apart from meeting its vision statement of providing a fillip to the development of the region, NRL has actualized its role in the nation building process as one of the premium oil and gas companies in Assam with national and global footprints. Your company continues to scale newer heights with satisfactory physical performance and best ever results across key performance indicators, such as specific energy consumption, LPG bottling, GEM procurement, and CAPEX in the last financial year. We are hopeful that the same would translate into impressive financial results. Today, NRL is the threshold of high growth and major strategic projects in the pipeline, which would further add to its capabilities while embarking in new fields such as green hydrogen, biofuels, and petrochemicals. The onus is now on all of us to coherently put our best efforts for accomplishing the task for us with utmost commitment and dedication. Today, it has been a privilege for oil to take the majority stake in NRL and being the major stakeholder last year. It is a win-win for both the companies as it charters the road ahead as an integrated oil behemoth focused on the growth and progress of the region. Needless to say that oil and NRL have a very special place in the hearts of the people of Assam, where both the companies have grown. The central government as well as the state government have laid huge emphasis on Act East policy with focus on creating long-lasting business relations with neighboring countries on the northeast frontier of the country. Together, oil and NRL will be able to play a pivotal role in contributing towards fulfilling the vision. With the massive refining capacity enhancement project of NRL and aggressive exploration plans of oil in existing and new hydrocarbon blocks in the northeast, oil and NRM will be able to contribute immensely in ensuring energy security of the nation and achieve the target set by the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas and the Northeast Hydrocarbon Vision 2030. EIL is also present in the ownership of NRL, and their presence in the consortium will further boost the technical expertise, which will become more relevant considering the expansion plan of NRL. I must also appreciate the contribution of NRL towards civil society and the general public. NRL has always gone above and beyond its corporate social responsibilities to actively pursuing welfare measures for the people living around its area of operations. NRL has also among the most notable contributors to our collective efforts during COVID-19, supporting the relief, vaccination and medical efforts of the states and central government. In fact, yesterday there were good programs arranged by NRL. All of us went to various CSR projects, and it is our pleasure to be a part of those functions. We have seen how NRL is involving people in different worlds. And on this auspicious day of Foundation Day of NRL, this was a very good initiative taken by the NRL management. I thank Sri Bhaskar Jyoti Phukan for this initiative. And for your information, yesterday we had board meetings of both the companies here on the eve of Foundation Day. And this is, I think, for the first time probably, both the board meetings at NRL. I once again congratulate all the members of Team NRL, including associate entities and valued business partners, including vendors, contractors, and customers, and sincerely hope that they will continue to sustain their enthusiasm and momentum as they march ahead with their indomitable spirit. A special thanks to the family of all NRL well-wishers who have stood behind as historic support at all times. My best wishes to all of you, and thank you for your kind attention. Jai Hind, Namaskar.